Hi guys, and welcome back. I have another fun project for us, summer related. As I mentioned, I'm gonna try to work on some summer projects, even though we're winding down to the end of July. We still have a lot of summer left here in North Carolina. So I have a cute project tonight with one of our A size transfers, and it's sunshine is my favorite color. And I have not done this one yet, so I'm looking forward to it. And I've got a couple different colors of oranges and yellows that I'm going to kind of work with all on this. You could do it all in one color and one yellow, but you know me, I've got to have a variety. So I've already figured out exactly how I want to do it. And I've got my colors all laid out, and I'll tell you what they're called as I use them. And for the first time, I'm going to show you our couture pillar, board and pillar stand. So this is a really cool little device. I mean, you could use this in your kitchen. You can use it in your living room, in your entry area, on your table. I can just think of so many uses for it. It is one of our top quality. It's called a boutique board, chalkboard, which means it's reusable over and over and over and over. So this is very durable. It is not double-sided, although I suppose if you wanted to paint it on this side and use it, you could, but it's not made double-sided. And then it comes with this nice heavy wood pillar stand with a little screw in the back that holds your board in place. You can place it this direction, horizontally or vertically, either way. So for our purposes, obviously, we're going to do it this way. I'm going to take it off of the stand while we're working on our project. I don't need to do anything at all to prep the surface because it's all ready to go. All I need to do is prep my transfer since it's brand new and it's going on the chalkboard surface. I want to make sure that I fuzz it several times. And fuzzing, as I've mentioned before, is just exactly like what it sounds. This is a silkscreen transfer. You see the white area is the silkscreen area, and that's the area that our paste, which is actually just wet chalk, is going to go through the silkscreen area onto our surface and create our design. And then the teal area is just a fabric that holds everything together. So I'm gonna put my little backing aside, and as I've mentioned before, we have a shiny side and a matte side to our backing, and the shiny side is the side that the sticky back of the transfer needs to be attached to when you put it back on. And these directions all come on the back of your, they come in a plastic sleeve, and it has instructions on the back, and it tells you that information. And it's on our website, or you could always message or message me or ask for a comment. So I'm just going to fuzz this. I know you can't see it. Let me see. I'll get this out of the air. I got my glasses close by so I can read the paste. So this is our fuzzing cloth, and that's available in my online shop as well. But you can use any type of fabric. You could use your shirt. You can use whatever you want. A hand cloth, something. I've gotten these cloths from the dollar store, just microfiber type cloths, anything. And the whole idea is, because it is sticky on the back, we want it to adhere to our surface, which is obviously important, but we don't want it to be so sticky that it doesn't pull up or it might damage our silk screen. So we just put some fuzz on it, on the sticky part, to make it just not quite as sticky. And since it's a new one, I'm gonna do it like 3 or 4 times. And I'm just using the side of my cloth that has the tag on it. The other side is more of a microfiber side. You use that side for drying your transfers. The way you clean your transfers is you just run them under cold water. We do have a board eraser that can help. Let's see if I have one right here. I think I had one. I don't. I'll show you before we get off. But you can use that to also help clean your transfer, but usually just a little bit of water, cold water, will clean it right off. Especially if you do it right after you finish your project. And that's what you want to do, to try to save the life of your transfer. They are reusable anywhere from 8 to 12 or 15 times, depending on how well you take care of them. And I'm just trying to center this as best that I can. And if I don't have it centered, it is sticky, so it's grabbing a hold, but not so much that I can't pull it back up. And then replace it. We have several different surfaces that this will work on. This is a 5x7 transfer. As I mentioned, it's an A size transfer. We have so many different surfaces. We have box frames. We have our board and base. You can find all of our surfaces online as well on my store. I don't know why I'm having trouble. Let's try it upside down. Sometimes that works best for me. And if you find your own frame, you can do it on a canvas, you can do it on glass, plastic, metal, fabric. You could do it on a t-shirt. If you wanted to have a t-shirt that says sunshine is my favorite color, that would be fun. You would want to use our ink instead of the paste. The ink is permanent after it's heat set. Let's see. Let's just get it on here. Sunshine's not perfect anyway, right? Our paste will dry hard to the touch and doesn't take very long to do that. But it won't come off until you're ready for it to come off. You can wipe over it with a damp rag to clean it if you needed to, or if you wanted to change it off, for example, as I'm using it on this surface, and then when fall gets here, if I want to put something different on here, or I have another cute transfer that I want to try out on here instead, maybe I'm having a party and I have something that's party related. Could have worked for 4th of July. You want to make sure you get all the bubbles out. This has a lot of silk screen area, so that's the only reason why I think I'm having a little bit more. I have to go a little slower because it has a big silk screen area. A lot of our transfers don't have big silk screen areas. They have lots of little cutouts, which is why it's so much better than using a Cricut and doing all that weeding. And I see, goodness, guys, this is what's taking the longest. Sorry about that. I see a piece of fuzz that I don't want there. You do want fuzz on there, but if you have something in your silk screen, like you see something and it looks like it might mess up your, hang on a second, I'll put my reading glasses on, that it might mess up your, yeah, it's a big ol' hair, hang on. See, dog, I don't know what that was. Is that dog hair or lint? Yeah, that would have messed up my paste where it would lay. Because of that. So just pull anything like that off. You do want fuzz on there to help you, but you don't want it to get in your way of your silk screen area. So if you see something like that, take it off. Okay, I think I got it on there now. What was I saying? Guys, I forget so easily, especially by this time of the day. Okay. All right, so the colors that I'm going to use are, this one's new, this is orange peel, this is a new one for me, and golden hour, which is so pretty. I love that. And then my bumblebee and my mixture. When I made my sign that's up there over my shoulder, I mixed some colors together to make my own orange because I didn't have an orange at the time. And so I mixed bumblebee with some red. I can't remember if I added white too. And I made my own orange. So I had a little bit of that left over and I just scraped that out of the jar. And I'm gonna use that on just a few areas. And since I have a couple different size areas, I have 4 different colors I'm using. I wanna use a different squeegee. These are our mini squeegees. This is one of our small squeegees. And this is a small squeegee cut in half. So I'm probably gonna use I'm gonna probably use this one, the cut in half one, for my yellow, because those are the bigger areas I'm gonna do. For these little teeny tiny areas, I also have 2 multi-purpose tools. This is a multi-purpose tool, and this is also a multi-purpose tool. So as you can see, these have squeegees on the end too, different sizes. So I'll probably use this one for these little teeny tiny openings. And then maybe I'll put it this way so you can see it while I'm working on it. And then I'll use this one for the next. And I'll use this one for the big, yeah, I don't know. I may wipe one off. We'll see. I've got enough. I just trying to think what I want to do. Okay, so to start with, I am going to use, I believe I can do all this fast enough that I don't have to do the paste and pull, but if I get to this point, I may do that just so that I can show you, but I don't think I'm going to have to. I think we'll be all right today. So I'm going to take this orange that I made, and I had to kind of dig in my little jar because I just had a little tiny jar when I did it. And I'm just going to put some of it right on my little squeegee here. And then I'm just going to push it right into my silkscreen areas. And I'm not going to try to make it real thin this time. I'm going to do it a little bit thicker so that I don't have to paste and pull. And because I'm not going to probably try to put this back in the jar. Now that I have an orange, I'm happy with it. I can always work with that orange or make it a different shade of orange if I want to now that I have an orange. So those two spots I decided would be my homemade orange. And I know you might say, why are you using orange in the sun and sunshine? But to me, I feel like it has some orange in it. I know it's usually very bright. I think I'm thinking more of maybe even a sunset, but just make sure you cover your silkscreen area. Just making sure I got plenty of paste. And our paste is washable if you get it anywhere. Usually you have a baby wipe by a hand or on hand or a wet paper towel so that if you get it on your fingers or if you get it on an area of your surface that you don't want it, you can just wipe it right off. Plus you can also use it to clean your squeegees with. Okay, so next we're gonna go to the next color of orange. So our nice bright, actually I have some here. I can just get off of the squeegee. I had to stir it because I had not used it yet. It was new. Love it. It's a pretty color. So this is probably, you can always add more, but I definitely have too much there. So we'll just move some of that up here. And you can do this any way you want. You could do it quick and easy with just one color. Just bumblebee, throw it on here, and be done. And it would probably take you longer to clean your transfer than it would to actually make the project. You do you. Whatever works for you. Whatever makes you happy when you're crafting. I really needed this. I spent the day doing a lot of business type work. Work, so I was hoping to get a chance to do some crafting today. I'm just making sure that it's on my silkscreen area. I go both directions just to be sure. And you just put any extra back in your jar. So easy peasy. And then next, we're going to use. I think I decided I was going to do this one in the bright yellow, this one and this one and that. This one I may blend actually a little bit. You know, I have to do something. I may even just use my fingers. That's another good reason to have a baby wipe to blend that, those two colors together. And I'm going to take a tiny bit. Probably don't want to put that back in. I can't tell because it's going to be, I'm going to use my finger. Let me go ahead and get a baby wipe. Now, baby wipes for your fingers, and you can also use a cleaning wipe on your actual transfer if you need to. Some of the colors will stain, but as long as you get it cleaned out of your, as long as you clean it out of your silkscreen area, you're good. You just don't want your paste dried in there, otherwise it won't work good next time. So I'm just gonna wipe that on that wet paper towel and then just use a wipe. Okay, so now I'm going to take my little squeegee and do the next one. We have have several shades of yellow. We have a couple different ones of orange. We have like a papaya and a guava. So I guess they would kind of be orangey, shades of orange. And of course, we have our lovely shimmer pumpkin for the fall. And then there's several shades of the yellow as well. So this is the golden hour. We have daffodil. We have the bumblebee. I can't think of what other colors, but you can look in my online shop and see all the different shades. They have made a lot of the paste into, these are the 3 ounce jars that will last you a very, very long time. And I'm not going to be, you can see I got a little bit of that other orange in there. If I did, I'm not going to be totally upset because I don't mind if it blends a little. I may actually even make it blend. See? Blends into another. I am cool with that. Ooh, see, now I got an idea. I'm gonna do it. So I'm just blending some of the colors. Okay. Put that aside. Fingers clean again. And then onto the yellow. And I'm just gonna do the sunshine, the word part in yellow as well. It's looking pretty, don't you think? I haven't even finished it and it's already pretty. Okay, let's get our bumblebee. Yeah, I'm not sure I can't think of the other color yellows. There's a pretty harvest. I don't know if you watched my video, but there's a harvest, a shimmer harvest, which is a golden color, as you can imagine. I could have even used that on here because it's shimmery. And the sun is shimmery. I'm gonna do both of these in yellow, I think. I don't know if I'll blend. I never decided, maybe. I'll add a little mixture into each other on the sides. Sorry, thinking. Sometimes our fingers are our best tools. Okay, clean that off and then I'm gonna do my big sunshine area. Making a mess. Just pushing it into the silk screen area and pulling it along at the same time. Flip it around so that I can't believe I haven't used this board and pillar yet. It's one of my favorite pieces and I just haven't done a project on it yet. And I was looking for a surface and I was going to do this on one of our pennants. It would fit, the size is perfect, it would fit. And I was gonna do it on one of those, but then I was concerned that the yellow just wouldn't show up that well on the, you know, it's like a drop cloth color. It's that kind of canvas. So I didn't want to take a chance that it wouldn't show up. So I decided I would do it on this. So there we go. It's all on there. Let's see. Hopefully I did not wait too long to pull it off. We start at the corner and then pull down straight. And there you have it. That is, if that doesn't have a 70s vibe, I don't know what does. I don't know. I thought of the Partridge Family when I saw it for some reason. Oh my gosh, is that not the cutest? I know I have a glare. I have to have the light on. It's already dark here. Oh my gosh, that is so cute. Isn't that just cheery and fun? Sunshine is my favorite color, I can tell you that. I don't mind a rainy day here or there, but for the most part, I have to have sunshine. I'm a solar panel. Are you more of a rainy day person or a sunshine person? Anyway, doesn't need anything else really to make it gorgeous. That's all you do. And that will be dry in about 5 or 6 minutes. I could speed it along with my heat tool or my dryer if I wanted to, but I don't need to. I'm not planning on touching it. Looks like I maybe just had that go in a little too much on that part. So might have to touch that up with some paint, but there you go. And you can just put that wherever you want to spread some sunshine. You set it right in the base. It's got a little screw back here to tighten it so it doesn't fall. And I think, like I said, I think I must have tightened it too much. I'm not sure. But look how cute that is. Isn't that awesome? I love it. And I'm glad I blended it. I think that makes the colors kind of go, make more sense together because I did that. So let me know what you think. Isn't it adorable? And if you're interested in this transfer, that's available in my shop too. And I can help you get to that if you need any help. The colors, like I said, they've made a lot of our paste into the ink, no, but the paste into singles. I think I've shown the single packets before like this, but I'm not sure if all of these colors are singles. You might be able to get just the yellow, one of the yellows maybe. But isn't that great? I love it. And you can do it on any size that will fit a 5x7. Anything you can find that will fit a 5x7, whether it's in my shop or out on your own. All right, that's it for tonight. Making it short and sweet. I hope that brings some sunshine to you. I appreciate you checking in with me, and I enjoy doing this project with you. Hope you have a great day.